In local rugby action today, Barry hosted the Barbarians from Aurora ahead of the start of the regular season. A bit of a soggy day out at Jim Hamilton Field in Midhurst. The Barry boys take the lead. Jesse Ledbetter with the knock-on setting up the Sky Blue try as the home team keeps it coming in the second half. Aurora can't seem to adjust defensively as Evan McDonald finds Ledbetter on the far side, and this young man has wheels.
This game, that's right, Barry RFC taking on Brantford. Let's take a look at what happened at the Springwater Complex. There's a look at Brantford. Barry, the number one ranked team.
Rugby players were just some of the people giving the gift of life today during a blood drive in Barrie. 21 players from the Barrie Rugby Rec team were taking part in the drive. The team wanted to give back to the community, and they figured that donating blood was a very good place to start.
It is kind of neat that we're all coming together and we're donating blood. But yeah, most times a rugby game can get pretty rough. So it's kind of funny that some of us here, especially me, are getting a little nervous, a little prick, rather than a big guy running at you.
One more pass, Reese! One more pass!
Blonde hair blowing in the summer wind, a blue-eyed girl playing in the sand. I'd been on a trail for a little while, but that was the night that she broke down and held my hand. The teenage rush, she said, hey, we all just runaways, we got time, that ain't much, we can't wait.
I'm Ethan.
Nova.
Drew.
Rachel.
Rick Doran.
Dwayne Farrell.
Kim Noble.
Oh, I'm Hannah.
What do you like most about playing rugby?
Probably contact, hitting people, rucking.
I like the team dynamic.
I like the intensity of the sport and the team bonding experience.
The whole like team aspect of it. I've met a lot of like close friends through Barry and school, so that's just always what I've liked about rugby.
How do you feel rugby is different than other sports?
Well, you're talking more, I find.
Just because like in certain positions, you have to be like really close to one another, so you have to like let go of a lot of things.
It's more of a team sport. Like you play together, you try together, you tackle together.
I feel like we work together a lot more, and we're more like brothers.
What skills or character pieces do you think playing Barry rugby has taught you that you can carry over into other parts of your life?
Be patient, be respectful, always listen to like your boss, same as like listening to your coach.
Work ethic, definitely.
Determination, like when you don't want to do something, you have to do it.
It's definitely made me a lot more mature in the sense of like just problem solving.
Do you see yourself playing rugby in the future?
I certainly hope so, yeah.
If you could choose three words to describe your experience playing Barry rugby so far, what would they be?
Pretty damn awesome.
So Natasha, being part of the women's team here, why did you decide to play and what are some of the things you enjoy about the team?
Well, this is my first year. I played in high school for 3 years and then decided that first couple years of university would be a good time to relax and not do any sports, and then I decided that wasn't fun either, so decided to join the team. It's really good. I've met a lot of new girls here and it's good being active. It's really good. I find it's good for your mental health, physical health.
I think I value hanging out with the guys, the camaraderie. It's a really good group of guys, and we all get along well. We socialize together and come out and have great games on Saturdays. It's just a good mix.
Anytime you can be part of something that's been around for 50 years is special. And it's a special season for us as the women, having a team back and being part of all the festivities that have happened this season.
I think it's awesome that we're here for a tradition.
One big thing I value about the team is it's a fun mix of having a good time, staying in shape with the competitive edge. And after taking a year off, everyone came together knowing it was a work on rebuilding year, and it's been a lot of fun, and it's really included in the rest of the club, and all the club likes to get together and support one another. I like it a lot.
Something I value about the team and the club is that it keeps me busy during the summer. So instead of being on my butt all day, I'm out here playing rugby. Another thing is that it like brings all the schools together. So like I just played a season of rugby for school, beating everyone up, but now they're all on our team and we can get together and beat other people up, so that's pretty fun too.
The cooperation, the communication that we have, the parties that we set up before and after practices, after games kind of thing. I love how everyone's super friendly and inclusive about our team. With the club, I just love how you can practice with the men's team if you wanted to before your team's actually starting your season. I love how inclusive the club is with everyone. It doesn't matter what age you are.
The structure and teamwork that the coaching staff and more, I guess, more importantly, the club itself has established as a goal is to work and play for each other and try to create a community rather than just the team that plays a sport.
Being that rugby is one of the only competitive sports that adult women can play in the area, what do you value about that? And do you enjoy that the game hasn't been modified from the men's game, like say hockey or football?
Yes, in high school I had to play flag football because they claimed that there weren't enough women to hold a tackle football team, which was strange because there was 50 girls on the rugby team.
Definitely empowers everyone to grow as a team, and then it's good socially.
It means a lot. I mean, I don't really understand why other sports don't follow the same rules. Girls can definitely handle it, and being a part of a team that shows that girls are just as tough as guys and they can play with the same rules, it hopefully just spreads through other sports and through other women.
As a parent of a player on the U18 women's team, what do you feel that rugby has brought to your daughter?
A lot of commitment to sport. She's changed from being a competitive dancer and decided to commit to rugby full time. A lot more organized about her plans on how to develop. She takes notes on how to make herself better as a player. So just in general, that's helped her.
So your son is new to the club and he's on the boys U16 team. How has his experience been so far?
It's been great, thanks. He's quite enjoying it. It's a big team. So he's getting lots of experience and able to play a lot of different kids.
In terms of the coaching that you're seeing, are you happy with how the practices are run and the skill development of your son?
Absolutely. They practice the important skills. They practice the pace, which I firmly believe is the most important. And I think it shows in the amount they've improved in the short time I've been watching.
As the player development coordinator for the Barrie Rugby Club, tell us a little bit about what you do for the youth programs and what your goal for the youth players is.
So the big thing that we've been implementing with all of our players is first of all having a good pathway for our players all the way from juniors straight through to the men's. So that's making sure that we're teaching our players all of the core skills that they need to succeed in any system or any place that they go and play. But on top of that, we've really tried to be a little bit more inclusive as a club and make sure that our players understand that while we want to be competitive, we also want to have a big rugby community in Barrie where we're inclusive, we're getting together, we're doing stuff together, and basically having fun for everybody.
So as coach of the Barrie men's team, what are your three main priorities?
For me, it's about challenging the players. I want them to be better players, but also better people. That's always a big thing. I want to put them in a position to learn more, to acquire more skill, to develop a little bit more understanding of the game, to put them in a place where they're going to learn as they play. And then for me, the big one is they're enjoying themselves. They should be having fun. That's why we all got into this game. And hopefully that enjoyment transfers down into the next generation of player.
Chase, this is the club's 50th season. What does it mean to you to be part of something like that?
It's awesome because there's like a bunch of like people who are from the old days and can help lead us into it. So it's awesome seeing people who've been playing for like the past 30 years on the men's team and stuff. And like they can kind of be leaders and like bring people up so that soon it could be 75 years and then 100 years and stuff like that.
That's a huge deal. 50 years is a long time to me. And knowing that the club just started with one team at its inception, it's really impressive to know it's grown to what it is today with all the different age groups and women's and men's teams and minis.
Searching for something, something never comes, never leads to nothing, nothing satisfies, but I'm getting close, closer to the prize at the end of the rope. All night long, I dream of the day, when it comes around and it's taken away, leaves me with the feeling that I feel the most, feel it come to life when I see your ghost.
leave.